One of the fundamental features of a prototype is that it acts vaguely like the final app when it's interacted with, but is much simpler to make. This means that when we build a prototype, we need to think about interaction points. An interaction point is anywhere that a user might press, scroll, or type in order to interact with your app. By identifying the interaction points for your app, you will identify where you need to link screens together and what work you need to do to build a prototype. For a low-fidelity prototype, we only need to deal with interaction points that will move the user between screens, not interaction points that will allow them to input content. For example, let's take a look at our calendar and to-do list app. This app has a floating action button, or FAB, which we can expect users to touch. And on the screen that opens, it has a number of other options. We can expect users to try to interact with each of them in the final app, but since they don't add another screen, we don't need to deal with that functionality here just yet. On our menu screen, each item leads to a new screen. Fewer menu items means fewer screens to build, but also a reduced functionality. Finding a balance there is vital. We don't want to remove any core functionality in order to have fewer interaction points, but you can probably go without a terms and conditions option in your lo-fi prototype.